everybody, welcome to my blog. So today we're going to talk about warts and veruccas, which is a really common thing that I see as a problem in GP. So, to start with, what are they? So they are small rough lumps that grow from the skin that are caused by the human papilloma virus. They can appear absolutely anywhere on the body and their type can dictate where that is, but we mainly find them on the hands and the feet. On the soles of the feet, they're called veruccas, but they are still absolutely a form of warts. And they're also harmless, and that's really important to remember. They're unsightly and they're sometimes painful, but they're harmless. So as I've said, they're caused by the human papilloma virus. The virus infects the skin and it causes it to thicken up, to get very coarse and sometimes rough. They can spread person to person by skin contact. So if someone's got a wart on their hand and you touch that wart, you can catch it. But the risk is very low, and they can spread from contaminated contact with floors and other surfaces the warts come into contact with, which is why we often see people thinking about showers and gyms and swimming pools. They are more likely to spread if your skin is wet or if it's damaged, you have an injury. So again, we come back to swimming pools. Self-infection is also very common. So touching them, picking them, scratching warts or veruccas can spread them. And as a child, I was a swimmer, so I had more of these than I could possibly count. And I also got one under my thumb now where I was constantly touching and picking. So don't is the warning from experience. They're more likely if you've got a weakened immune system. We'll come on to that later. So what are the types of warts that we find? So the common wart is firm and round. It has a rough surface which can look like a cauliflower on the top. It's most common on the hands and the knees, funnily enough, and it's from a few millimetres to 1 centimetre in size. A plain wart or a flat wart is round, smooth, sometimes yellow, and it's flat or only very slightly raised. Quite often found on the face, the back of hands and legs. And you can have one or you can have hundreds. So, you know, as I said, they're very different in their types and how many of them you get. So the other wart we've talked about on the feet is a verruca. And the other name for that is a plantar wart. And that's because the sole of your foot is actually your plantar surface. And that's where you're most likely to get verrucas. They have rough skin over them, hard skin, and they can have tiny black dots in the middle of them as well. They can be painful, and that tends to be the hard skin that's causing that pain. They're flat, and you can have lots and lots of veruccas, and they can sometimes join together. So you start with clusters of a few of them, and they join together to cause a bigger verrucca called a mosaic wart. So those are the types. What are the symptoms? Well, they're unsightly, they don't look very nice, so that's the most important reason people come to me. They don't really cause symptoms, but sometimes, as I've said, that hard skin can cause pain. So there's a clue there in terms of what we have to do about them. They can catch on things and they can bleed. And sometimes they can be painful near the nail bed, so when you have them on your hands and they're at the side of the nail, that can be painful. And common warts can often crack and bleed. And obviously that can be painful because you've broken the skin. So how do you diagnose a wart? How do you know what it is that you've got? Well, I would always say go to the pharmacist. Pharmacists are experts and lots of minor things that we get, and they can actually have a look at it for you and tell you what they think it is. If it's on your face, however, or it's not going away after whatever treatment you choose from the pharmacist and you use it for the correct amount of time, and we'll come on to that, then see your GP. It is important to see your GP if you have a compromised immune system. So for example, if you're taking medications like methotrexate, sulfasalazine, infliximab, which people often take for Crohn's or arthritis. If you have lymphoma, which is a type of blood cancer. If you've had an organ transplant, so you're taking anti-rejection drugs. Or if you've had stem cell treatments or chemotherapy, then please see your GP. You may need a different approach. So can you prevent getting warts or veruccas? So the answer is kind of. Don't share towels, socks or shoes. That's really important. Don't touch other people's warts or your own. Wear shower shoes in any communal areas, swimming pools, jacuzzis that you go to where there are other people that you don't know. Cover warts or veruccas when you're swimming or using communal areas. And so quite often I used to have to wear a sock when I was swimming. And this is a plastic sock that just goes over your foot, covers the veruccas and allows you to swim. And they're very easy to get online if you just Google verucca sock. Don't scratch them, pick them, as we've already said. Don't use a file or a pumice on your wart, on any other body part. So if you are filing away the dead skin, which is a good idea, keep that file just for those veruccas. Don't then use it on your hands because you'll spread the warts. So what are the treatments? Well, most warts or veruccas will go, wait for it, within 10 years in an adult. So that's how long you're looking at for the body to get rid of it, but it might be sooner than that. In a child, half will go in a year and 2/3 will go in under 2 years. So in children it's quicker, their immune system gets rid of them. So leaving them is often the best option because treatments are fiddly, expensive, time consuming, and they can be painful and have side effects. Most people will seek treatment if their warts or veruccas are painful, unsightly or not going away. Many treatments are out there. There are lots and lots. There is no evidence at all that any of them are better than the others or really that any of them work quicker than your body will rid you of them anyway. So let's start with the treatments. So medicinal treatments that you can get from your pharmacy include plasters, creams, gels and paints. Most of them contain salicylic acid, which softens that hard skin that we've been talking about. And that's what allows the medicine to then get to the verruca. You can't use these on your face, which is why you should see a GP if you have them on your face. You must also see a GP if you're diabetic, if you have any loss of feeling in toes or fingers. It's crucial because you will be more at risk of complications. It's really crucial to file off that hard skin first before applying the treatment. If you apply the treatment over the hard skin, it won't get to the actual heart of the verruca or the wart and nothing will change. So it's important to do that and it's a crucial part of the ongoing treatment that you have to do for quite a while. 3 months at least is the minimum treatment duration, and filing in between each treatment to get the hard skin off is really important. You mustn't get the gel or the paints or the creams on the surrounding skin because that would just cause a wound. So sometimes people use Vaseline around it to stop the treatment leaking outside of the actual wart or verruca. And as I've said, you can need to do the treatments for up to 3 to 6 months. So what about cryotherapy, which is freezing? You will know it as freezing the wart. Well, yes, that can be done. It can be done by a GP, but it isn't part of core NHS duties anymore. So there is no obligation on a GP to have a cryotherapy kit within their surgery. If you've got one, you're lucky. And I've worked in some that have and some that haven't. It's not paid for within many CCGs. You can buy over-the-counter freezing treatments and they do work. I've used them. So I can recommend that, but do them carefully, obviously, and use some Vaseline around the edge again. You need to repeat the freezing treatment that you buy over the counter every 2 to 3 weeks for up to 6 months. Now, not always. Sometimes one treatment will get rid of a wart. But for those ingrained veruccas that have been there for quite some time, get that hard skin off first and see, but you may need repeat treatments. It's painful. It can lead to blistering and scarring, so it's not without side effects. It's not ideal for children because of the pain, and it mustn't be used on diabetics. So see your GP. There is no evidence that this works any better than any other treatment that we're talking about today. So what about surgery? So very, very rarely would we refer you to a minor surgery unit to have surgery. And it may only be available privately. It's important to know. So the surgical technique is to either scrape it away by curettage or using a laser to burn it away. 30% of veruccas or warts removed by surgery or laser come back. So you need to know that. So what about other treatments? There are hundreds out there. So I've picked off a few of the more common ones for you. Don't laugh. So the first one is banana skin. You cover your verruca or your wart with the inside of a banana skin or peel, and you bandage it in place overnight. You repeat every night until it's healed, and it may take weeks, but people out there swear by it. So you can be taping your banana skin to your foot or your hand or wherever it is overnight and see if that works. Duct tape. So that's proper household duct tape. You put a small piece of duct tape over the wart or the verruca and you leave it for 6 days. And then you soak before applying the next one. You leave it for 6 days, you take it off for one, and then you put the next one on. But you soak and get rid of any hard skin before you put back that next one for 6 days. And you need to repeat this for several weeks. There are lots of scientific papers out there on duct tape, and it does seem to work. We're not sure how. But so that's another solution. Then there's apple cider vinegar. Now, apple cider vinegar seems to be becoming very common to treat any list of ailments that you can possibly think of. But there are lots of people out there that say it works. And you dilute 2 parts of apple cider vinegar to 1 part water. You dip a cotton ball in it, and then you put that onto the verruca or the wart, and you tape it there again. So you're using tape to make your own plaster with this apple cider vinegar on it. You leave it every night, and you repeat this every single night until the verruca or the wart has gone. There is another way of using apple cider vinegar, which is you can soak the affected area for 15 minutes a day in apple cider vinegar solution with water and rinse it off when it's done. So that's another option for you. I can't vouch for any of these, of course, but people out there do swear by them. And as we know that no treatments really work better than any others for warts or verrucas, it doesn't seem like there's any harm in trying. So in summary, warts and verrucas are harmless. They will resolve on their own in most cases, most. No treatment is proven better than any other treatment, and it really isn't. Doesn't matter if it's laser or banana skin. Seek GP help with verrucas or warts if you're a diabetic or if you have an immunocompromised system. And if you do treat yourself from the pharmacy or any of the other ones, the bananas, duct tape, etc., it's crucial to get the hard skin off before you start the treatment. Because you need to get to the heart of the verruca, and the hard skin is there protecting it in its own little cocoon. So that's really important as well. Don't share those files around any other body parts or you will make the situation worse. So hopefully that's helped and given you some suggestions to what to try for your warts and verrucas. I will put some information afterwards, as always, with any evidence for the duct tape, because it is out there. And suggestions for the rest of the alternative treatments. If you've got any questions or I haven't covered something for you, please let me know in the comments afterwards. If you've got any topics that you want me to cover in the future weeks that I can do in more depth once baby's here and we have a routine, please let me know. And as ever, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate your support. Take care.